दोस्तों, लर्नर जोन में आपका एक बार फिर से स्वागत है। जैसे कि मैंने अपने पिछले वीडियो में बताया था, मैं हर एक इंडस्ट्रियल एक्सपर्ट्स का इंटरव्यू करता रहूँगा और आप तक पहुँचाता रहूँगा, ताकि आपको थोड़ी सी मदद मिल जाए। जिस एरिया में भी आपका इंटरेस्ट है, उसमें आप ये डिसाइड कर सकें कि उस पर्टिकुलर डोमेन को आप कैसे मास्टरी कर सकते हो। तो इसी रिलेटेड आज हमारे साथ है मिस प्रियंकिनी। सो इन्होंने अपना पूरा करियर एज अ टीचर गुजारा है। करेंटली शी इज सर्विंग एज अ पब्लिक स्पीकिंग ट्रेनर इन एन इंटरनेशनल स्कूल। सो वेलकम प्रियंकिनी फॉर द शो।
थैंक यू सो मच विदेश फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी एंड आई एम ऑनर्ड टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ
योर। इट्स माय प्लेजर एब्सोल्युटली।
सो
वुड यू लाइक टू टेल लिटिल मोर अबाउट योर डोमेन, योर वर्क एक्सपीरियंस टू आवर ऑडियंस?
श्योर। हेलो अमेजिंग पीपल। सो एज विदेश हैज ऑलरेडी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड मी, सो आई एम अ पब्लिक स्पीकिंग ट्रेनर एट एन इंटरनेशनल स्कूल एंड आई हैव worked with like people of almost all age groups, right from the person who is preparing for CAT exam to people from sales background. So and now I trained small kids from grade 1 throughout grade 8, so that's what I do.
Oh, so you mean to say you are training the people of all age groups?
Yes.
You are training to the kids, you are training to the trainers, you are training to the teachers, and also to the professionals.
Yes, also Montessori. I have taught Montessori teachers on spoken English. Yeah.
So have you found any difference in them after going through your training? How does a Montessori kid will understand how to modulate it? I mean, how to go about the speaking skills?
Well, see, normally the activities are based on their age.
Okay. Got it.
Like they have very small activities, as small as like K1, K2 kids will just come and take one object and say, okay, hello, my name is so and so, and I'm going to talk about this in two lines about this.
This is very interesting,
yes,
actually.
Yes.
Okay. Can you please tell us a little more about what does the public speaking means?
Public speaking is simple, like speaking in front of an audience is public speaking. Now, when I say how, it's a big chapter. So let me give some tips on this. So
before she starts giving tips, I would request you to take pen and paper so that you can note down the tips, because these are the very valuable tips what she will be doing, she will be giving, and it will not be available afterwards.
Yes, you should better do that.
Yeah.
So number one tip is organize your thoughts. So learn to organize your thoughts before you speak. Now, when I say organize your thoughts, how to do it? Now, different people have different ways of doing it. You can just jot down in a paper the points so that you know what to speak and you speak to the point.
Okay?
Now, second tip is, you should have the outcome clear in your mind as to what you need to convey.
That's so that we should not deviate from the outcome and talk what we are going to proceed with.
Exactly. So and you have to be very clear as to, is the audience going to benefit from that? So that is the outcome. That should be very clear.
Okay.
Third tip is, your language should be very simple.
Okay.
Like people should not, they do not have to, bring their dictionary and refer while listening to you. That's very important. And the fourth and the most important tip is the energy. Energy and emotion. So people always remember that the audience, they do not connect to your words. The only thing they connect to is your energy. So that's
really true, because I, being a coach, I have experienced it several times. Whenever I'll be giving a talk on the stage, I always try to keep my energy level very high.
I have seen that, Varish. You're really good at that.
Thank you very much.
When you go to the stage, it's your energy that speaks.
That's really true.
Yeah.
So, please let us know how one can get mastery over it.
Okay. So, practice. So, not only public speaking, whatever the domain is, whatever you take, the only thing you will gain expertise on it is through practice. That's what I want to say. Now, when I say practice, so it depends what you choose, because public speaking itself is a very broad topic, right?
Yes.
So it depends what you choose. Like, for example, if you want to be a keynote speaker, so you have to work more and more on, how to speak. You can take part in a panel discussion, you can lead to give some presentations, you can conduct your own seminars, webinars, and keep speaking as much as opportunities you get. You just keep speaking. Initially, you can start off with, providing some free sessions to some colleges or some corporates and then start charging for it.
Okay.
So that way you can do. And on the other hand, if you want to be a YouTuber or if you want to anchor to be an anchor in a TV show, so you have to keep in mind that you have to work, you have to practice on your speaking as well as facing the camera. So that
awesome.
Is important. Yeah.
So I need to learn from you then. Because I'm coming on YouTube again and again now.
My
so
gosh.
I'll be keep coming now. So I think not only you, I'm also going to get some benefit out of this particular interview.
Yes,
I feel.
We will learn from each other, don't worry.
Yeah, fine. So let us know one thing. What was the deciding moment in your life which has made you come into this particular profession? And
okay.
How that particular decision have changed yourself as a person? Is it going to make any impact in people's lives?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
So about the deciding moment, let me tell you that no doubt I decided this, that I'm a very good teacher at the age of 20. Not 20, even before that. Maybe I was 19 when I was in the first year of my engineering.
Wow.
So, well, before that in grade 12, you know, I started teaching my friends around.
Nice.
And, you know, in the first year of engineering, as I told you, I was one among the topper of the college.
Oh.
So exactly, you know, 10 days before the semester, there used to be a huge line in front of my corridor. So my friends used to come to me to study.
That's
so
nice.
You know, in that case, we both used to benefit mutually.
Correct.
Because after teaching them, I used to gain so much of confidence in my own subject.
True.
That I never had to look back and do some revision or something. I'm already.
Correct.
So you know, when
when you start teaching somebody else, you will become more and more perfect at it.
Yes, yes, and I gained so much of clarity on that subject.
Yeah.
So I was very confident that, you know, I'll be a very good teacher.
Okay.
But yes, after that, you know, I was not able to pursue my career as teaching because of a lot of hurdles, as you all people have, but always follow your passion, guys, you know. So what happened is, you know, after it took me, yes, I have wasted around 10 long years in pursuing other careers because of family pressure, this and that.
Mm-hmm.
So I worked with UCO Bank for some time, I worked with Wipro for some time, I was a science teacher in an international school, and then I decided that enough was enough because I was not happy and I wanted to narrow down my area of expertise towards one particular field. So I have started public speaking again.
Mm-hmm.
And so I trained, you know, as I told you, like different age group people, and I trained Montessori teachers. Yes, this was the deciding moment when
okay.
I taught Montessori teachers for 2 long months.
Mm-hmm.
Now, on the Montessori training, so spoken English was a module, so I was taking care of that. And after that, you know, the kind of confidence I got in myself was mind-blowing. You know, I was so confident, I was so happy inside that I started believing in myself.
Okay.
I started believing that, you know, I can teach spoken English to anybody in this world.
That's
so
awesome.
That was the deciding moment where I decided that, you know, I'll take this career ahead.
Awesome. Yeah. Now that you have already told us how this has changed your life and how one can get mastery over it.
Yes.
I would request you to elaborate a little more on for what kind of people this particular field will be suitable, because that is the biggest question everybody will be having in mind.
Yes.
Because I have seen people who will be very scary to talk to one-to-one also.
Yes.
So I have so many people in my family who are very reluctant to talk to one another. Okay. I have so many friends who are very reluctant to talk in public. So when they can't speak sitting in the audience, how can they go and speak on the stage?
Yes.
So when you talk about public speaking, so there has to be some qualities imbibed in some people who can get the mastery over it. And those are the people, some people are made for something. Just like I feel that I have been made for coaching. So what are those qualities which are required, which someone should possess, which can help them in growing in this particular domain at the faster rate in comparison to the others?
Very good question. So, thing is, I would say anybody can do public speaking. So,
okay.
Anybody who has the passion, I mean, who love to talk to people, share their stories to people,
okay.
And they can listen to people, they are good enough to do public speaking. Now, I have used this word anybody. You know why? Because 90% of people, they think that public speaking is an optional skill to learn.
Okay. Like that's how everybody considers it.
Yes, we may learn, we may not learn. Let me tell you, friends, it is not like that. It's a very important skill. Whether you are teaching somebody or whether you are closing a sale, you need to talk in front of people. No matter whether you are at the initial stage of your career or the middle stage or at the topmost position of your career, you need to talk in front of people. And that's a skill.
It's not only regarding the profession, but I would like to say one thing. I have spent my 12 years of my career in sales and business development. And despite of that, I have so many friends. So when we focus on improving our public speaking skills, it will also help us in our personal as well as professional life as well. So after going through this particular training, one can understand how to talk to elders, how to talk to the kids, how should we modulate our voice. Am I right?
Yes.
So whatever I have learned throughout my career, that's what I'm trying to explain here. So this may also help to the help to handle our personal relationships also.
Yes, definitely. When I say people, now these people can be your seniors, your juniors, your colleagues, your clients, your employees. Yeah, they can be even investors, right?
Okay.
Now even if you talked with 10 people in a room, these 10 people have 10 different perspectives about you, right? And organizing your thoughts in a way that to make these 10 people understand is a skill, my dear.
Awesome. Yeah.
So if you learn this skill, you will grow.
That's really true. And if somebody wants to be in a management position, then this is the highest level of skill what one should possess.
Yes.
Because all of my managers were awesome speakers. No matter what is the result they are getting from the field, but how they put it in front of the management and the board, that matters a lot. And that's what I have realized throughout my career.
Yes, definitely.
Now, if I want to understand,
I would like to tell, when you ask like how to gain expertise, so I have a tip that always learn from the expert who have already developed an expertise in this field.
Right, that is very much important.
That's very important because, for example, I loved public speaking like anything. So always I have followed two people like Ram Bhatnagar and Praveen Wadalkar. I have taken up their courses, I have, you know, attended their workshops, their events, and I have watched almost all their videos available in the YouTube, in the internet. So, you know, it's very necessary to have your own role model, like whom you want to become.
Okay, just one question on this.
Yeah.
Since you are saying that, follow the expert in particular domain.
Yes.
Okay, since you are aware that there might be so many different experts available in the market already.
Yes.
So how one should decide to whom to go? Whether should they decide with the accessibility? Because what I feel is, if I come to the person, if I go to the person who is very accessible, that will benefit me. Rather than going to someone who is far from me and talking to him on internet or WhatsApp or something like that. So I prefer to talk to somebody who is one-to-one.
Yes.
So what do you suggest?
That's a very good question. Thing is, you know, you need a lot of research on this. Like you start listening to people who are experts in this, and then I mentioned people like Rahul Bhatnagar and Praveen Wadalkar. These people are really approachable. You can even talk to them in phone.
Okay, that's good.
Thing is, like they have their courses available online at a very low price.
Okay.
You can even, it's your choice. Like you can take those courses, or if not, you can watch the free videos which they have on YouTube, and they are really influential and they are really, you know, knowledgeable videos which you can implement.
That's really a very useful information which you have shared. By the way, do you also have any such kind of courses or planning to have some courses like this?
Yes, definitely. I'm starting my new course, that is Speak Out.
That's awesome then.
Yes.
So, for all of our viewers, on their behalf, I'm going to take some discount for sure from you.
Sure. That we'll discuss later.
Definitely. And now, can you please just elaborate a little more on what is the scope of this field? If somebody is really passionate about this particular field and they want to make a career in this, then what is the level of scope available? and what is the level of earning that they can make?
Okay. So as all of you know, and you also know, that the scope of public speaking is vast, right?
Okay. Correct.
Now when we look into jobs, so I categorize into job and business. So when I look into jobs, you don't know the scenario of jobs as to after one decade what the jobs would look like in the market.
Correct. Absolutely.
Now, when we come to public speaking, let us talk about corporates and then international schools, colleges. Mm-hmm. So in corporates, you can be a corporate trainer, a process trainer, or a soft skills trainer.
Okay.
Now, when I look at international schools and colleges, they have already incorporated public speaking as a part of their curriculum.
Okay.
So they have huge demands. They are looking out for public speaking trainers now.
Even if somebody becomes a public speaking expert, then they can either they can work as a freelancer or they can get hired by somebody.
Yes,
even
yes.
By the multinational companies, I would say.
And the income is huge.
Oh, that's
true. I'm a part of it. I do agree with you
because I have witnessed some of the speakers who were coming as a guest speakers in our seminars, in our yearly conferences, and they were getting paid almost around 2 lakh rupees per day.
That's it?
Not even per day. They used to give a speech of
2-3
hours at max.
Yeah.
They'll be speaking everything about the motivation, how to grow in their career, and what are the mistakes we need to avoid in the process, and all those things. But they, as you rightly said, they used to come very prepared with the in an organized manner.
Yes.
Keeping the outcome in their mind. Whenever we talk to them, whenever we ask them weird questions, they always
prepared
for that, and they used to get us back onto the track.
Exactly.
On what they wanted to deliver.
Exactly. So that's a skill, right?
Yeah. Right.
And it's simple. It's not a rocket science, let me tell you. It's very simple.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So yes.
For people like you, it might look simple, but
no, it's not like that.
Okay.
So when we come to business, so like you can be a trainer, you can be a TEDx speaker, you can be a keynote speaker, you can organize your own seminar, webinars, or you can launch your own digital product. As a speaker, you can talk to different people, like you can even listen to their stories, you can attend national and international events.
Mm-hmm.
Now you can be a public figure, you can be an influencer.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fine, Priyankini, it was a very nice and very informative interview, and the inputs given by you. So on behalf of all our audience and from the Learners Zone community, I would like to thank you from the bottom of my heart. And
thank you so much, Viresh. It's my pleasure being here, you know, in your show. I mean, seriously.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot. I'll be sharing Priyankini's number in the description below. If somebody wants to contact her for more details, and if you want to make your career in public speaking as a speaker, then she is the right person, I would say.
Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.
Keep going. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.